Hi everyone, it's Kay here. Thank you very much for joining me today while I do another Junk Journal January make. This is for prompt 19, which is interactive. So I've got some things cut out ready to go. This is 7 1/4 across and 5 inches down. And I'm going to fold that in half like that and stick it down. If I can find the end, that'd be good. There it is there. Using just some double-sided tape, because every time I use my glue, I get probably a little bit too further in than I'd like sometimes. So just make sure that I've got just enough. Just got a little bit on the end that I didn't consider. Hope you are all good. We're good. We just have to get our car fixed, so no car for today and tomorrow. But this is way in advance, so by the time you see this, we'll have my car back. Like, we've only got the one car. We decided when we both retired that we didn't need to have two cars. We can manage with just the one. So, and so far, it works out well. Did I fold that properly? That's interesting. Obviously my fold wasn't very straight. So apart from that, I just, as you know, don't like the heat. That's always a bit of a problem. So I'm going to create a specimen kind of pocket here. I've already got the acetate on the back. If you don't have acetate, you can use the plastic on packaging. So I'm going to put that down there as well. This is a variation of one I've made before on my channel, where I did the pocket all the way where they did the cut all the way through to this pocket and just had the one thing. But I thought, oh well, just do something a little bit different today, creating a bit of a double pocket. So I have two things to be interactive with. Don't have a plastic bag today for my soft plastic. Forgot to put one in. So just to throw it over here and pick it up later. So this is all from a uniquely creative collection called Industry Standard. So it's got all these wonderful coggy type elements and excuse me, sorry. And cogs and grunge and things like that. So it's already come up. From the, I have to. Oh, I didn't want to do that, did I? Okay. Yeah. So that's gonna. I'm just gonna use a tag from the collection and pop it down there like that. I'm gonna just stick that down and wait for it to dry a little bit. Put a little bit of a hole here. Too close to the top. A bit of a string. This came off some packaging, so they are something I bought. I think Etsy shop. So just recycling that. I gotta be careful, I did it a bit too close to the edge there. I'm gonna pull it too hard, but okay. I knew it. Knew it. I always forget when I do things and then I pay the price afterwards. Plastic is, the acetate has come up, that's what half the problem is. That's, I'm sticking that on the acetate. So hopefully that works. Okay, that can go there. And then for the tag that's going to go in this pocket here, I'm going to use some things. This was in my stash. I've had it for ages, so just been going through some of my boxes and things. I'm thinking, oh, they've been sitting there for ages, I may as well use them. Sort of transferring some things from small boxes to bigger boxes. I'm going to actually stick that back down again so that you've got, because I quite like the edge there. So I'm just going to stick that back down. Then I'm going to use another element here from my stash. This came from a scrapbooking supplies little kit from Amazon. So I've got all these wonderful elements. I've got the owl, which I love. I've got this wolf. I've got koala. Awesome. So it's surrounded by cogs. So again, I'm going to use this leftover cord because I think it looks rustic, like the collection. But that isn't a bin. I think maybe I should have done that this way around for that one over there. Looks better. Alright, so that's going to go in there. It's not stuck down enough. Not enough glue, everything's drying so quickly because it's so warm. Sorry, just realised how softly I was talking. Put that down there. Let's come off of this acetate as well. Goodness me. I think it's just the heat's just not making everything dry so quickly, it's just not sticking. I've got this little label, this also came from the collection, and a star that I thought I would put in the corner here, and I'll put a number on the label. So let's follow my number. That's a good number. 785. Oh, let's do. Since I've got this, I might as well use it to the ground espresso. So I use the ground espresso. I want to say espresso, but it's probably espresso. For inking around the edges. So like I said, these are the measurements for the cross. That was the measurements for this here, from 2 and 3 quarters to 3 7/8 down. And the hole in the middle is 1 3/4 across and 3 3/4 down. And the tag at the back is 3 across and 5 1/4 down. So that's why those measurements are there. If I want to take a screenshot while I'm fiddling with that. But I know that lots of people could probably do this without having any measurements. Leave this, so hopefully you can see it. Let's have a look. Are you sure you can see it? Oops, I turned you off by mistake. I'm sorry about that. Hopeless. I was trying to move you so you could see. Try again. Yep, that's better. No, whether I should put that up there a bit more, maybe. That's better. Actually, what I want to do is cut off this extra stuff and just have the blue edges. Scraps out of the way. And pop it there. All right, so that's my interactive. I want to do nature as well. I'm just going to pop this away. I'm just going to turn you off for a little while I tidy up a little bit. Back in a minute. Sorry about that. So I'm just going to leave those there so you can see the measurements, just in case you needed a bit more time. Well, perhaps I should put them on that side so they're not inundated with other things. I've got this book here. I think it's the Wildflowers of the Adelaide Hills, I think it is. No, can't be. Can't remember what's got to take the cover off, which is not sensible of me. It's a fabulous book. And I'm just going to take a page out because this, I thought it was for South Australian, but I think it's maybe, yeah, I think it is. It's a South Australian nature book. It's got all these beautiful images in there. So I'm going to take this one. Not too sure which one to take now. Got something that's sort of possibly that I wouldn't use. Not on. This is lichens. Let's use that one. I like this book because it's got the pictures on one side and the words on the other, so you're not feeling that you're sort of having to choose which one you want. So I'm just going to use my knife here to hopefully go through the page. No. I'm going to make an envelope, hopefully. This is not straight, so just need to get a ruler for a moment and line it up on the mat. Draw a line. I could use my knife, but no, my luck would probably rip the whole thing. Okay, let's have a look. So we need one there. One there. Could really have done it a bit further on, okay? You don't need to have that bit there, perhaps. Excuse me, you can't see, I'm just folding that bit over. Going to fold the top bottom up like that, and I'm going to open it up again. Which ones should I cut out? I can't remember. These ones on the side. First time I ever saw this being made was on Roxy's creations with her one of the weekly challenges last year, and I just hope I remembered it rightly. Okay, and then the top bit. How did the top bit go? Okay, how did the top bit go? It's folded again, I think. Downwards. Same thing again. Cut off the side bits. Oops. This bit's getting in the way here. Can't get my scissors in there properly. Going to snip that corner. And that corner, so they're more or less using it for the other side to sort of measure that side so it doesn't look so uneven. And that'll be my entry point into the envelope. So just need to make sure it's folded properly. Starters. Oops, that's ripped that now. Let's stick that down. That bit there's floating around. And cut that bit more. Side should I have on top like that. Yep, let's do that. So let's cut, stick this bit down. And this bit at the bottom goes up. Oh, I could have trimmed the sides of those as well, couldn't I? Oh well. Like you could have done a diagonal cut on there as well, that's what I was trying to say. And there's my envelope, ready for a journal, and I can decorate it however I like. So that was oh, I can't just keep leave it like that, neither do I. I need to have something on it. It says nature, so I need to have something on there that's nature-ish. Is that such a word? Is nature-ish? Probably not. Let me think. Just trying to think what I can use on there. Could use this. Anything I can use is nature-ish. Sorry. Can't remember. Possibly not. I want to put that there, or the black and white one. Do you know what? I think the black and white one goes well because of the colours of the background. What else have I got? There's another one there. There's a smaller. These are all from my stash. I've got various things. What's this one? The same as the one I put before, put it away. I think I had some rabbits somewhere, sorry. These are probably all too small. Not too thin for the whole thing. That's my story book. I think I might have to just leave that one on there, because I think that actually really goes. But I need something behind it. See, all of these pictures are, you have to create something around it, just not the thing that I want to have. Oh, actually, look at this. It's roses on there, though, it's the trouble in there. Tulips, does that clash? Decisions. Sorry. Should have got this organized before. I've got one organized but not the other. Oh, this, that's perfect. You know what, that's perfect there. I'm gonna put that there. Cut off the excess in a minute. And I'm going to put that, I am going to use this as a surround kind of thing. And put a little doily here, or a little photograph frame I could use. Put the two together. I think that looks better. Probably thinking, oh, she's wasting that tulip picture, but I need it just to create a background. I could just, whoops. So you took that off. It wouldn't be anything for the needs that there. I'm sure you've made these envelopes before. Don't even made anything really, book page. Any books, any papers, anything. This is a dormouse. Don't have dormouses in Australia, but still looks cute. I don't think it matches. So we've got backgrounds that are South Australian, dormouse which doesn't live in Australia. But that's lots of nature things there. I think that'll be my lot for the day. Just checking, just make sure I don't have, want to have anything else on there. I don't know, what about you, but do you think that's wonky? I think that's wonky. Probably can't get it up now. I was in trouble with using white glue. Can't shift things very easily if you make a mistake. off the background now. Oh. Just made a big mistake by moving it over, because now I can't cover this back bit over here. Just needs to have something. Cover that bit there. I don't have any. I had some. Oh, these are from Kmart. They're stickers. Kmart in Australia. another one just to sort of wrong way around. Okay. Okay. I think that'll do for the day. Make up my mind before I make any more mistakes. Thank you very much for joining me today with my two makes. We've got interactive and nature. Thank you very much for joining me today, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.